everyone. Congratulations on installing Aimtel for your web push notifications. Once you have installed our Shopify app, you will be sent here to our dashboard. This is where you will schedule all of your campaigns. Along the left side of the screen, you will see our navigation bar. Now that you have Aimtel installed, your website will start showing you an opt-in prompt to all users that navigate to your website. Let's take a look at a demo site to see an example of an opt-in message. Here you see the message pops up asking to subscribe to push notifications. All a user has to do is click allow, and they are instantly a subscriber and are loaded into your dashboard as such. Aimtel then continues to work in the background, recording your visitors' actions on your site, including things like geolocation, pages visited, items purchased, visit date, and a whole lot more. Later on, you'll be able to create target audiences using any combination of this data. I'm going to go ahead and opt in right now so that I can show you an example push notification in just a moment. Heading back to the dashboard, you were able to take a look at your subscribers by clicking here on the subscribers button on the navigation bar. A list will display of all your current subscribers. Once you've gained a few, you'll want to send your first campaign. You can easily do this by clicking the notifications button and then selecting manual notifications. Creating a campaign is easy. Simply click here to create your first campaign. Give your campaign a name, click Create Campaign, and you're brought to your content window where you input the info you want for the campaign. As you input the info, the preview will automatically update to give you an idea of how the push notification will look. Input your title, a custom icon, if you like, the main body content of the message, and finally, the URL you want your push notification to direct to. You can even click Send Test Push to see exactly how the notification will appear. Let's put in some sample info. Here's where you would change the icon. I'm going to leave it as this for now. And I'll put Aimtel in as the destination URL. When you are finished, click the Recipients or Schedule tab to decide who gets sent this campaign, as well as when it gets sent. The Recipients tab lets you select a segment or segments if you do not want to send your campaign to all of your subscribers. Simply check the box next to the segments you wish to send this campaign to. I'm going to select all subscribers. Finally, the Schedule tab lets you decide when to send the notification. You can also decide if you want this campaign to be sent once or more than once by clicking the appropriate button down here in the automation section. When you are happy with your campaign, hit schedule and it will send according to your schedule. I'm going to pick a time close to now so that you can actually see an example of a notification being sent. No repeat, and click schedule. Great. Now that the campaign has been scheduled, it will send at the given time that you have selected. When the time comes, your notification will be instantly delivered to your subscribers, which, when clicked, drives them back to your store or the link you specified in your campaign. I've gone ahead and scheduled this campaign now, as I said, so that you can see exactly what our notifications look like when they are delivered to your subscribers. A great feature of Aimtel's is that your subscribers do not even have to be at your website in order to receive your notification. I'm going to close out of the demo site, and as you will see, I will receive the message when the scheduled time comes. Close out. And there it is. Even though I was not at the website, and in fact I was not even using a browser, the notification is still delivered. As you can see here, the URL of the website I subscribe to is displayed at the bottom of the push notification, and when you set up your campaign, your website will display here as well. Clicking the campaign pulls up the website you input as the destination URL, in this case, aimtail.com pulls up, just like we set up. One final feature to mention that you can set up right away is an automated abandoned cart campaign that will target subscribers who put items in their shopping cart but do not complete the purchase. For Shopify users, we automatically track abandoned carts for you. You can easily activate this campaign by clicking the notifications menu here, as is already selected, and selecting triggered notifications. A template for an abandoned cart campaign is already there for you. Click Edit to customize the notification. And as you'll see, the window looks the same as it did for the manual notification that we set up a little earlier. Under the Trigger tab, you will see that the abandoned cart command is already input. You don't have to change anything. Clicking the Delay tab lets you decide how long to wait before the campaign is triggered. As you can see here, a 1 hour delay is already in place, but you can input a number to add on to that 1 hour delay if you like. When finished, hit Activate down here, and your campaign is set up and will trigger automatically going forward. If at any time you have a question, click the blue chat bubble down at the bottom of the screen and send your question. Someone will get back to you as soon as they can.